Martin B-26 Marauder. Design and Development. In March 1939, the United States Army Air Corps issued Circular Proposal 39-640, a specification for a twin-engined medium bomber with a maximum speed of 350 miles per hour, 560 kilometers per hour, a range of 3,000 miles, 4,800 kilometers, and a bomb load of 2,000 pounds, 910 kilograms. On July 5, 1939, the Glenn L. Martin Company submitted its design, produced by a team led by Peyton M. Magruder, to meet the requirement, the Martin Model 179. Martin's design was evaluated as superior to the other proposals and was awarded a contract for 201 aircraft, to be designated B-26. The B-26 went from paper concept to an operational bomber in approximately 2 years. Additional orders for a further 930 B-26s followed in September 1940, still prior to the first flight of the type. The B-26 was a shoulder-winged monoplane of all-metal construction, fitted with a tricycle landing gear. It had a streamlined, circular section fuselage housing the crew, consisting of a bombardier in the nose, armed with a .30 in, 7.62 mm, machine gun, a pilot and co-pilot sitting side by side, with positions for the radio operator and navigator behind the pilots. A gunner manned a dorsal turret armed with 2.50 in, 12.7 mm, machine guns, the first powered dorsal turret to be fitted to a U.S. bomber, while an additional 0.30 in, 7.62 mm, machine gun was fitted in the tail. Two bomb bays were fitted mid-fuselage, capable of carrying 5,800 pounds, 2,600 kilograms, of bombs, although in practice such a bomb load reduced range too much, and the aft bomb bay was usually fitted with additional fuel tanks instead of bombs. The aircraft was powered by two Pratt & Whitney R2800 double wasp radial engines in nacelles slung under the wing, driving four-bladed propellers. The engines were manufactured at the Ford Dearborn engine plant in Dearborn, Michigan, USA. The wings were of low aspect ratio and relatively small in area for an aircraft of its weight, giving the required high performance, but also resulting in a wing loading of 53 lb/sq ft, 259 kg/m superscript 2, for the initial versions, which at the time was the highest of any aircraft accepted for service by the Army Air Corps. The first B-26, with Martin test pilot William K. Kennebel at the controls, flew on November 25, 1940 and was effectively the prototype. Deliveries to the U.S. Army Air Corps began in February 1941 with the second aircraft, 40-1362. In March 1941, the Army Air Corps started accelerated service testing of the B-26 at Patterson Field, Ohio. Accidents. The B-26 relatively small wing area and resulting high wing loading required a high landing speed of 120 to 135 miles per hour, 193 to 217 kilometers per hour, indicated airspeed depending on load. At least two of the earliest B-26s suffered hard landings and damage to the main landing gear, engine mounts, propellers and fuselage. The type was grounded briefly in April 1941 to investigate the landing difficulties. Two causes were found: insufficient landing speed, producing a stall, and improper weight distribution. The latter was due to the lack of a dorsal turret. The Martin power turret was not yet ready. Some of the very earliest B-26s suffered collapses of the nose landing gear. It is said that they were caused by improper weight distribution, but that is not likely to have been the only reason. The incidents occurred during low-speed taxiing, takeoffs and landings, and occasionally the strut unlocked. Later the Martin electric dorsal turret was retrofitted to some of the first B-26s. Martin also began testing a taller vertical stabilizer and revised tail gunner's position in 1941. The Pratt & Whitney R2800-5 engines were reliable, but the Curtiss electric pitch change mechanism in the propellers required impeccable maintenance, not always attainable in the field. Human error and some failures of the mechanism occasionally placed the propeller blades in flat pitch, resulting in an overspeeding propeller, sometimes known as a runaway prop. Due to its sound and the possibility that the propeller blades could disintegrate, this situation was particularly frightening for aircrews. More challenging was a loss of power in one engine during takeoff. These and other malfunctions, as well as human error, claimed a number of aircraft and the commanding officer of the 22nd Bombardment Group, Colonel Mark Lewis. The Martin B-26 suffered only two fatal accidents during its first year of flight, from November 1940 to November 1941, a crash shortly after takeoff near Martin's Middle River plant, cause unknown, but engine malfunction strongly suggested, and the loss of a 38th Bombardment Group B-26 when its vertical stabilizer and rudder separated from the aircraft at altitude, cause unknown, but the accident report discussed the possibility that a canopy hatch broke off and struck the vertical stabilizer. Due to the need for training many pilots quickly for the war, a number of relatively inexperienced pilots entered the cockpit and the accident rate increased accordingly. This occurred at the same time as more experienced B-26 pilots of the 22nd, 38th, and 42nd Bombardment Groups were proving the merits of the bomber. For a time in 1942, pilots in training believed that the B-26 could not be flown on one engine. This was disproved by a number of experienced pilots, including Jimmy Doolittle, who flew demonstration flights at MacDill, which featured takeoffs and landings with only one engine. In 1942, Glenn Martin was called before the Senate Special Committee to investigate the National Defense Program, or Truman Committee, which was investigating defense contracting abuses. Senator Harry Truman, the committee chairman, asked Martin why the B-26 had issues. Martin responded that the wings were too short. Truman asked why the wings were not changed. When Martin said the plans were too far along and besides, his company already had the contract, Truman's response was quick and to the point: in that case, the contract would be cancelled. Martin said corrections to the wings would be made. By February 1943, the newest model, the B-26B10, had an additional 6 feet, 1.8 m, of wingspan, plus uprated engines, more armor, and larger guns. Indeed, the regularity of crashes by pilots training at MacDill Field up to 15 in one 30-day period led to the exaggerated catchphrase, "One a day in Tampa Bay." Apart from accidents occurring over land, 13 Marauders ditched in Tampa Bay in the 14 months between the first airplane on August 5, 1942 to the final one on October 8, 1943. B-26 crews gave the aircraft the nickname Widowmaker. Other colorful nicknames included Martin Murderer, Flying Coffin, B-Crash, Flying Prostitute, so named because it was so fast and had no visible means of support, referring to its small wings, and Baltimore Whore, a reference to the city where Martin was based. According to an article in the April 2009 edition of AOPA Pilot on Kermit Week's Fantasy of Flight, the Marauder had a tendency to hunt and yaw. This instability is similar to Dutch roll. This would make for a very uncomfortable ride, especially for the tail gunner. The B-26 is stated by the 9th Air Force to have had the lowest combat loss rate of any U.S. aircraft used during the war. Nevertheless, it remained a challenging aircraft to fly and continued to be unpopular with some pilots throughout its military career. In 1944, in answer to many pilots complaining to the press and their relatives back home, the USAF and Martin took the unusual step during war, of commissioning large articles to be placed in various popular publications, educating and defending the so-called flying/accident record of the B-26 against slanders. One of the largest of these articles was in the May 1944 issue of Popular Mechanics. Operational history. The B-26 Marauder was used mostly in Europe, but also saw action in the Mediterranean and the Pacific. In early combat, the aircraft took heavy losses, but was still one of the most successful medium-range bombers used by the U.S. Army Air Forces. The B-26 was initially deployed on combat missions in the Southwest Pacific in the spring of 1942, but most of the B-26s subsequently assigned to operational theaters were sent to England and the Mediterranean area. By the end of World War II, it had flown more than 110,000 sorties, dropped 150,000 tons, 136,078 tons, of bombs and had been used in combat by British, Free French and South African forces in addition to U.S. units. In 1945, when B-26 production was halted, 5,266 had been built. Pacific Theater. The B-26 began to equip the 22nd Bombardment Group at Langley Field, Virginia, in February 1941, replacing the Douglas B-18 Bolo, with a further two groups, the 38th and 28th, beginning to equip with the B-26 by December 1941. Immediately following the Japanese attack on Pearl Harbor, the 22nd BG was deployed to the Southwest Pacific, first by ship to Hawaii, then its air echelon flew the planes to Australia. The 22nd BG flew its first combat mission, an attack on Rabaul which required an intermediate stop at Port Moresby, New Guinea, on April 5, 1942. A second group, the 38th, began receiving B-26s in November 1941 and began transitioning into them at Patterson Field, Ohio. There, the 38th continued the testing of the B-26, including its range and fuel efficiency. Immediately after the entry of the United States into World War II, plans were tentatively developed to send the 38th BG to the Southwest Pacific and to equip it with B-26BS fitted with more auxiliary fuel tanks and provisions for carrying aerial torpedoes. Three 38th BG B-26BS were detached to Midway Island in the build-up to that battle, and two of them, along with two B-26S detached from the 22nd BG, carried out torpedo attacks against the Japanese fleet on June 4, 1942. Two were shot down and the other two were so badly damaged that they were written off after the mission. Their torpedoes failed to hit any Japanese ships, although they did shoot down one Mitsubishi A6M0 fighter and killed two seamen aboard the aircraft carrier Akagi with machine gun fire. Notably, one of them, Susie Q, after dropping its single torpedo and searching for a safer escape route, flew directly down the length of the Akagi while being chased by interceptors and anti-aircraft fire, which had to hold their fire to avoid hitting their own flagship. From approximately June 1942, B-26 squadrons of the 38th BG were based in New Caledonia and Fiji. From New Caledonia, missions were flown against Japanese bases in the Solomon Islands. On one occasion, a B-26 was credited with shooting down a Kawanishi H-6K flying boat. In 1943, it was decided that the B-26 would be phased out of operations in the Southwest Pacific Theater in favor of the North American B-25 Mitchell. Nevertheless, the 19th Bombardment Squadron of the 22nd BG continued to fly missions in the B-26. The B-26 flew its last combat mission in the theater on January 9, 1944. Two more squadrons of torpedo-armed B-26s equipped the 28th Composite Group and were used for anti-shipping operations in the Aleutian Islands campaign, but there are no records of any successful torpedo attack by a USAF B-26. Comedian George Gobel famously joked about being a trainer for this aircraft at Frederick Army Airfield, now Frederick Regional Airport, during the Pacific battles, boasting that not one Japanese aircraft got past Tulsa. Mediterranean Theater. Three bombardment groups were allocated to support the Allied invasion of French North Africa in November 1942. They were initially used to carry out low-level attacks against heavily defended targets, incurring heavy losses with poor results, before switching to medium-level attacks. By the end of the North African campaign, the three B-26 groups had flown 1,587 sorties, losing 80 aircraft. This was double the loss rate of the B-25, which also flew 70% more sorties with fewer aircraft. Despite this, the B-26 continued in service with the 12th Air Force, supporting the Allied advance through Sicily, Italy, and southern France. Air Marshal Sir John Slessor, Deputy Commander-in-Chief Mediterranean Allied Air Forces, wrote of the astonishing accuracy of the experienced medium bomber groups, particularly the Marauders. I think that the 42nd Bombardment Group in Sardinia is probably the best day bomber unit in the world. Schlesser in fact meant the 42nd Bomb Wing 17th, 319th, and 320th Bomb Groups, but a U.S. wing equated roughly to a British group, and vice versa. Northwest Europe. The B-26 entered service with the 8th Air Force in England in early 1943, with the 322nd Bombardment Group flying its first missions in May 1943. Operations were similar to those flown in North Africa with B-26s flying at low level and were unsuccessful. The second mission, an unescorted attack on a power station at IJmuiden, Netherlands, resulted in the loss of the entire attacking force of 11 B-26s to anti-aircraft fire and Luftwaffe Focke-Wulf FW-190 fighters. Following this disaster, the UK-based B-26 force was switched to medium-altitude operations, and transferred to the 9th Air Force, set up to support the planned invasion of France. Bombing from medium altitudes of 10,000 to 15,000 feet, 3,000 to 4,600 m, and with appropriate fighter escort, the Marauder proved far more successful, striking against a variety of targets, including bridges and V-1 launching sites in the build-up to D-Day, and moving to bases in France as they became available. The Marauder, operating from medium altitude, proved to be a highly accurate aircraft, with the 9th Air Force rating it the most accurate bomber available in the final month of the war in Europe. Loss rates were far lower than in the early, low-level days, with the B-26 stated by the 9th Air Force as having the lowest loss rate in the European theater of operations at less than 0.5%. The B-26 flew its last combat missions against the German garrison at the Isle d'Oléron on May 1, 1945, with the last units disbanding in early 1946. British Commonwealth. In 1942, a batch of 52 B-26A Marauders, designated Marauder I by the RAF, were offered to the United Kingdom under Lend-Lease. Like the earlier Martin Maryland and Baltimore, these aircraft were sent to the Mediterranean, replacing the Bristol Blenheims of No. 14 Squadron in Egypt. The squadron flew its first operational mission on November 6, 1942, being used for long-range reconnaissance, mine-laying and anti-shipping strikes. Unlike the USAF, 14 Squadron made productive use of the equipment for carrying torpedoes, sinking several merchant ships with this weapon. The Marauder also proved useful in disrupting enemy air transport, shooting down considerable numbers of German and Italian transport aircraft flying between Italy and North Africa. In 1943, deliveries of 100 long wingspan B-26 C-30s, Marauder II, allowed 2 squadrons of the South African Air Force, 12 and 24 Squadron, to be equipped, these being used for bombing missions over the Aegean Sea, Crete, and Italy. A further 350 B-26 FS and GS were supplied in 1944, with 2 more South African squadrons, 21 and 30, joining number 12 and 24 in Italy to form an all-Marauder equipped wing, while 1 further SAAF squadron, 25, and a new RAF squadron, 39 squadron, re-equipped with Marauders as part of the Balkan Air Force supporting Tito's partisans in Yugoslavia. A Marauder of 25 Squadron SAAF, shot down on the unit's last mission of World War II on May 4, 1945, was the last Marauder lost in combat by any user. The British and South African aircraft were quickly scrapped following the end of the war, the United States not wanting the return of the Lend-Lease aircraft. France. Following Operation Torch, the Allied invasion of North Africa, the Free French Air Force re-equipped 3 squadrons with Marauders for medium bombing operations in Italy and the Allied invasion of southern France. These B-26s replaced Lior et Olivier Leo 451s and Douglas DB-7s. Toward the end of the war, 7 of the 9 French groups de bombardement used the Marauder, taking part in 270 missions with 4,884 aircraft sorties in combat. Free French B-26 groups were disbanded in June 1945. Replaced in squadron service by 1947, 2 lingered on as test beds for the Snecma Atter jet engine, one of these remaining in use until 1958. Corporate operations. In the immediate post-war years, a small number of Marauders were converted as high-speed executive transports, accommodating up to 15 passengers. The specifications of the individual conversions differed considerably. The example shown in the image was completed in 1948 and had streamlined nose and tail fairings and windows inserted in the rear fuselage. It served United Airlines before being sold to Mexico. It was purchased by the Confederate Air Force and restored to wartime markings for air display purposes before being lost in a fatal crash in 1995. Variants. B-26. The first 201 planes were ordered based upon design alone. Prototypes were not characterized with the usual X or Y designations. They had Pratt & Whitney R2800-5 engines. Armament consisted of 2.30 caliber and 2.50 caliber machine guns. The last model was armed with nearly three times that number. Approximate cost then, $80,226.80/aircraft, 201 built. B-26A incorporated changes made on the production line to the B-26, including upgrading the 2.30 caliber machine guns in the nose and tail to 0.50 caliber. A total of 52 B-26s were delivered to the Royal Air Force, which were used as the Marauder MKI. Approximate cost then, $102,659.33/aircraft, 139 built. B-26B model with further improvements on the B-26A, including revised tail gunner's glazing. 19 were delivered to the Royal Air Forces as the Marauder MK.IA. Production blocks of the 1,883 aircraft built. At 23A or TB-26B 208 B-26BS converted into target tugs and gunnery trainers designated JM-1 by the U.S. Navy. B-26B single tail gun replaced with twin guns, belly-mounted tunnel gun added. 81 built. B-26B1 improved B-26B. 225 built. B-26B2 Pratt & Whitney R2800-41 radials. 96 built. B-26B3 larger carburetor intakes, upgrade to R2800-43 radials. 28 built. B-26B4 improved B-26B3. 211 built. B-26B10 through B-26B55 beginning with Block 10, the wingspan was increased from 65 feet, 20 m, to 71 feet, 22 m. To improve handling problems during landing caused by a high wing load, flaps were added outboard of the engine nacelles for this purpose also. The vertical stabilizer height was increased from 19 feet 10 inches, 6.05 m, to 21 feet 6 inches, 6.55 m. Armament was increased from 6 to 12.50 caliber machine guns. This was done in the forward section so that the B-26 could perform strafing missions. The tail gun was upgraded from manual to power operated. Armor was added to protect the pilot and co-pilot. 1,242 built. CB-26B12 B-26BS were converted into transport aircraft. All were delivered to the U.S. Marine Corps for use in the Philippines. B-26C designation assigned to those B-26BS built in Omaha, Nebraska instead of Baltimore, Maryland. Although nominally the B-26B10 was the first variant to receive the longer wing, it was actually installed on B-26CS before the B-26B10, both being in production simultaneously. A total of 123 B-26CS were used by the RAF and SAAF as the Marauder MK2. Approximate cost then, $138,551.27/aircraft, 1,210 built. TB-26C originally designated at 23B. Trainer modification of B-26C. Approximately 300 modified. XB-26D modified B-26 used to test hot air de-icing equipment, in which heat exchangers transferred heat from engine exhaust to air circulated to the leading and trailing edges of the wing and empennage surfaces. This system, while promising, was not incorporated into any production aircraft made during World War II. One converted. B26E modified B26B constructed to test the effectiveness of moving the dorsal gun turret from the aft fuselage to just behind the cockpit. The offensive and defensive abilities of the B26E was tested in combat simulations against normal aircraft. Although the tests showed that gains were made with the new arrangement, it was insignificant. After a cost analysis, it was concluded that the effort needed to convert production lines to the B-26E arrangement was not worth the effort. 1. Converted. B-26F angle of incidence of wings increased by 3.5 degree, fixed 0.50 caliber machine gun in nose removed, tail turret and associated armor improved. The first B-26F was produced in February 1944. 100 of these were B-26F1 MOS. Starting with 42 to 96,231, a revised oil cooler was added, along with wing bottom panels redesigned for easier removal. A total of 200 of the 300 aircraft were B-26F2S and F6S, all of which were used by the RAF and SAAF as the Marauder Mk3. The F2 had the Bell M6 power turret replaced by an M6A with a flexible canvas cover over the guns. The T1 bomb sight was installed instead of the M-series sight. British bomb fusing and radio equipment were provided. 300 built. B-26G B-26F with standardized interior equipment. A total of 150 bombers were used by the RAF as the Marauder Mk3. 893 built. TB-26G B-26G converted for crew training. Most, possibly all, were delivered to the United States Navy as the JM-2. 57 converted. XB-26H test aircraft for tandem landing gear, and nicknamed the Middle River Stump Jumper from its bicycle gear configuration, to see if it could be used on the Martin XB-48. 1 converted. JM-1P. A small number of JM-1S were converted into photo reconnaissance aircraft for the U.S. Navy. Marauder I. British designation for 52 B-26s for the Royal Air Force. Marauder IA. British designation for 19 B-26BS for the Royal Air Force. Marauder II. British designation for 123 B-26CS for the Royal Air Force and South African Air Force. Marauder III. British designation for 350 B-26F and B-26GS for the Royal Air Force and South African Air Force. With the exception of the B-26C, all models and variants of the B-26 were produced at Martin's Middle River, Maryland manufacturing plant. The B-26C was built at the Martin plant in Omaha, Nebraska. Operators: Turkey, France, Free France, South Africa, South African Air Force, United Kingdom, Royal Air Force, United States, United States Army Air Corps, United States Army Air Forces, United States Marine Corps, United States Navy, Women Air Force Service Pilots, Surviving Aircraft, France, B-26G. 44 to 68,219 dynamite, Utah Beach Museum, Musée du Débarquement Utah Beach, on loan from the Musée de l'Air de l'Espace in Le Bourget. It was previously recovered from the Air France Training School. United States. Airworthy. B-26. 40 to 1,464 part of the Fantasy of Flight collection in Polk City, Florida. On display. B-26. 40 to 1,459 Charlie's Jewel Maps Air Museum in Akron, Ohio. B-26G. 43 to 34,581 Chudin in National Museum of the United States Air Force at Wright-Patterson AFB in Dayton, Ohio. This aircraft was flown in combat by the Free French Air Force during the final months of World War II. It was obtained from the Mechanics Training School of French airline Air France near Paris in June 1965. It is painted as a 9th Air Force B-26B assigned to the 387th Bombardment Group in 1945. Under restoration. B-26. 40-1374 display by Hill Aerospace Museum, Hill Air Force Base, Utah. 40-1514 display by David Tala Chase Military Aircraft Restoration Corporation of Anaheim, California, at the Pima Air and Space Museum, adjacent to Davis-Monthan AFB in Tucson, Arizona. B-26B. 41-31773 flakbait 4 display at the Stephen F. Udvar-Hazy Center of the National Air and Space Museum in Chantilly, Virginia. This aircraft survived 207 operational missions over Europe, more than any other American aircraft during World War II. Specifications, B-26G. General characteristics. Crew, 7, 2 pilots, bombardier/radio operator, navigator/radio operator, 3 gunners. Length, 58 feet 3 in, 17.8 m. Wingspan, 71 feet 0 in, 21.65 m. Height, 21 feet 6 in, 6.55 m. Wing area, 658 ft2, 61.1 square meters. Empty weight, 24,000 pounds, 11,000 kilograms. Loaded weight, 37,000 pounds, 17,000 kilograms. Power plant, 2 times Pratt and Whitney R2800-43 radial engines, 2,000-2,200 HP, 1,491 kilowatts, each. Performance. Maximum speed, 287 miles per hour, 250 knots, 460 kilometers per hour, at 5,000 feet, 1,500 m. Cruise speed, 216 miles per hour, 188 knots, 358 kilometers per hour. Landing speed, 114 miles per hour, 90 knots, 167 kilometers per hour. Combat radius, 1,150 miles, 999 nmi, 1,850 kilometers. Ferry range, 2,850 miles, 2,480 nmi, 4,590 kilometers. Service ceiling, 21,000 feet, 6,400 m. Wing loading, 46.4 lb/ft superscript 2, 228 kg/m superscript 2. Power/mass, 0.10 hp/lb, 170 w/kg. Armament. Guns, 12×.50 in, 12.7 mm, Browning machine guns. Bombs, 4,000 pounds, 1,800 kilograms. Roll medium bomber. National origin United States. Manufacturer Glenn L. Martin Company. First flight November 25, 1940. Introduction 1941. Status retired. Primary users United States Army Air Forces. Free French Air Force. Royal Air Force. South African Air Force. Produced 1941-1945. Number built 5,288. Unit cost. $102,659.33/B-26A. Developed into XB-33 Super Marauder, unbuilt.
Please subscribe and thanks for watching.